So I am Captain Vinuta, serving in Indian Army as a medical officer since 4 years. So currently I'm posted in Jammu and Kashmir. So I welcome you all for this evening session. At the outset, I would like to thank Dr. Kishan. He's my immediate senior. So for this wonderful opportunity, today I will be speaking on medical career in Indian Army. So that is how you can join and basically your career after MBBS or after during internship. So you all must be having questions like, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Audible, ma'am.
Okay, I'm receiving messages saying that it's not audible. So yeah, you all must be having questions like whether to join army or not. How do you join? How can you join? How can I join? What are all the charter of duties? Where all you will be posted? Your role in this organization? Your growth personally as well as professionally? What are the advantages? What are the challenges? So let's go through each and everything. So first I'll start off with joining. The joining process, how can you join? There are three ways to join. First, as an undergraduate. Second, after you finish like 4.5 years of your academics as an intern. And third way is as a once you complete your internship as a medical officer. So for joining as an undergraduate, you while applying for NEET UG, that is when you apply for the exams, there is an option wherein you can opt for Armed Forces Medical College. Armed Forces Medical College counseling. Armed Forces Medical College is a premier institute and situated in Pune. So when you opt for that, once the results are out, the AFMC themselves will release the candidates who are eligible for the counseling, who are in that category, who have cleared those cutoff marks. So they will conduct this counseling, and there will be an interview for before you join the institute. This is the undergraduate. And if you are joining as an undergraduate, you will be joining as a cadet. So, and then there is internship, once internship program. So in this, you are joining as a, as an intern. So after, you will be completing 4.5 of your half years of your academics in private or government hospital, which are situated in throughout the country. So here there is a website online, that is www.amccentry.government.in. So you will apply they will call you for the interview whenever there are vacancies available. So far there are for this way, that is joining as an intern, they have called only twice. So till date, that is one in 2003 and one in the second time they had called in 2018. So there is when there is a requirement, when there are vacancy. So here you start off your career as an intern in any of the in one of the military hospitals with an academic setup or a academic backup. And then there is the third way, that is the like most of the times it is third way, because majority of medical officers start off their career as a medical officer after completing your internship. So here you have completed your internship. Again, there will be vacancies and callings available, and it is put up on this amccentry.government.in. So whenever there is a call, you just have to download the form and fill it up and apply. So they will call you for the interview with a short notice, like 1 week or 2 week or something, and then with the letter mentions where it is and where do you have to go and report. So I will go in detail how the interview and how what are all the things that is expected out of you. So in the interview, it is a panel of officers who are specialists and super specialists sitting in the round table with a presiding officer who is the senior most officer and the entire panel. So they will all first it will, the interview starts off with your background, where do you stay, why do you want to join army, and what are your hobbies and everything. And then they will start asking, going into the preclinicals and clinicals, your subject of interest, how much do you know about the subject of interest you are in. And then they will assess. There are in the panel, there are sitting psychologists and psychiatrists who will assess how well you cope up in the stressful situations. So basically, the interview is all about how well you communicate, how well you come out as a medical officer. And then after, once you clear your interview, in the same today you clear your interview, and there will be a next tomorrow they will announce and they will ask for your medicals. So medical, you will have to be fit in medicals. There will be a panel of tests like blood test, urine test, ENT, vision testing, and they will ask, screen you for this bodily deformities. There are chest x-rays and abdominal scan. So everything is done, and if you are clear, this all takes a day, and then the next day the results will be out. So this is about testing. And after the test, and once you are done, once you are clear with everything, the interview and the medicals, then you have to choose whether you want to, in this organization, you will be divided in Army, Navy, and Air Force. So you can choose Army, you can choose Navy, you can choose Air Force. So there are these three options. And then you are asked to choose a place or a city for joining once you get a joining letter. So you fall back after the interview, after the medicals, and they will send you a joining letter within 2 to 3 weeks with a time period of 1 month duration. So you will have a 1 month duration to decide whether to join, if you want to join, basically you can prepare yourself for 1 month. And then initially it is of 1 year of probation. The probation is for 1 year. So that is the period you are monitored. You are being monitored professionally, personally. So initial 2-3 months, it is a bit difficult because I am being very honest with my experience. So it is a period of your period wherein you integrate with this organization, adapt for this rules and regulations, the discipline, the do's and don'ts, and getting accustomed professional in this professional environment in this organization. So this is all about the joining. And then there is training. So within 2 to 3 months of your joining, at least within a year, you will get your training. The training is the basic course for all the medical officers that have joined over the period of a month or a year. So there, it's a batch of 200, 300 people wherein they come for the training, and the training is for basic course is for 6 weeks. This training you are trained superficially regarding this organizational structure, military law, weapon training, the march past, drills, endurance run, games and warfare tactics, combat skills and everything, crawling, mud crawling, whatnot that is available under this sun. And it is, I will tell you, this is, it pushes you to this edge, like mentally and physically you are drained out. And there are this regular routine tests, whichever the topic they have been teaching you. This endurance run, every single day you have morning routine, all the schedules you have to follow. It's a tight, jam-packed schedule. So basically you are put under stress and you are tested for mental and physical toughness. So you are trained for to manage during those extreme stressful situations, and how well you react or go ahead in the moment of crisis. How you will realize your full potential in these 6 weeks of course of training. So there are with all these things happening, and there are cultural activities as well, singing, drama, dance, and everything. So you develop a lot of association with your mates, fellow mates. There is a camaraderie, and you will learn how to be organized even in the toughest of times. So this is about training. It is very superficially I'm answering. If you have any doubts, you can ask me later. So then coming to postings. So postings, you are usually it's broadly categorized into piece postings and field postings. That is, piece postings are areas where it is usually a city or a town like Pune, Bangalore, Mumbai, Lucknow, Andaman, Kolkata, Dehradun. All these are piece postings. And field postings are, I will explain what is field posting. That is, it's a challenging, like operationally active areas, like challenging or in terms of terrain, challenging in terms of extreme weather, or challenging in terms of terrorism, counterinsurgency, or inaccessible routes. There are no accessibility to that place. So these are all the field areas. So J&K, Jammu and Kashmir, is counterinsurgency, belongs to that category. Leh, Ladakh, Siachen is a extreme high altitude, which is a extreme weather conditions. Arunachal is again terrain-wise and weather-wise challenging. So all these are field areas. So your posting in peace areas is peace area. It is for a 3-year duration, and in field you are posted for 2 to 2.5 years. And this peace posting and field postings, this rotation is after one field posting, you are posted to after one tenure of peace posting, there are 2 tenures of field posting. So each piece posting is for 3 years and field posting is for 2 to 2.5 years. So this is regarding this piece. And I would like to tell about this family. So there are dependents, your father, mother, or if you are married, your children, they are your dependents. So you are allowed to stay with your family, or you can... you and the organization will themselves provide you the ration and the accommodation facilities if you are in peace, for you and your family together. And if you are in field, the families are strictly not allowed. So this is the case in case of field. And the posting tenures, I told you 3 years of peace and 2 to 2.5 years of field. There may be an extension of 6 months based on the circumstances or the requirement of this organization. You cannot exactly, in every individual case, it will never exactly be 3 years or 2 to 2.5 years. Mostly 99% it is 3 years and 2 months. But there are chances that it might get extended based on the requirements, and that is operational requirements and the existing circumstances. So that is about this. And then there is, and professionally, I will explain what are the cases you will get to see in peace scenario and in field scenario. That is, in peace scenario, you are with the family and the dependents are also allowed. They are also cared for and they are also entertained in these hospitals. So usually these MI cases, all these pediatric cases, geriatric, upper GI bleed, infertility clinics, all these the branches are available. And basically, it's a tertiary setup wherein all the specialists and super specialists available. You might have already heard command hospital, military hospitals, wherein there are specialists who will take care of this medical needs. And then coming to the field scenario, it's usually a primary setup wherein you are the sole healthcare provider. So usually in the field scenario, wherein this basically these are operationally active areas. So these are along with the routine OPD cases, there are this gunshot wounds, lacerations, amputations, fractures, pneumothorax, the usual emergencies wherein you have to act very fast and quick, and then immediately send the patient to the secondary or a tertiary setup. So this is the field scenario. And in field, I would like to elaborate on field postings, because it's a very important part of this organization. So you as an young officer, when you have completed your 1 year of probation, and soon after your basic course training, you will be posted to a field scenario, that is a field posting. So you have a multiple role that you are not just a doctor, you are a soldier as well, and you are an asset in a field because you are the sole healthcare provider. So along with troops, troops are coming from the different backgrounds, from far villages of this entire country. So they come from a different background. They are also trained in various specialties like combat skills, infantry, artillery, armored, air defense, and different tradesmen as well, like cook or a hairdresser or a housekeeper. And everyone, there is, so there are many people who you are responsible for. And there are nursing assistants, medical assistants who are also trained, and they have a different institute and they are trained for this, mainly for basic pulse BP medicines, how to administer medicines, how to take pulse BP. So they are also posted as your assistants in field. So they will help you with the routine things. So you will have an OPD setup and medical stores, health section. So all this, you are the sole health when it comes to health of the troops. So you are the sole provider healthcare. You are responsible for their health, as their health in turn is responsible for our operational preparedness, our combat skills, the how the course of the operation and everything, how your preparedness to receive the casualties when there is an ongoing operation. So everything is dependent on how well you manage in field. So you are the in charge of this medical setup. That is basically, this setup is for primary setup. As I've already told you, in field, it's always a primary setup. You have given a medical OPD, small OPD with medical stores, IV fluids and medicines, routine medicines that are required, antibiotics and everything. So this, and health section, you're also, there is a health section wherein you have troops accommodation, different accommodation for the troops and for the tradesmen. There is a cookhouse for wherein the food is being prepared for the troops. So you have to monitor their health is like entirely. So it's an all-round thing wherein you have to monitor the hygiene and sanitation in cookhouse, whether the food being prepared is up to the standards, whether the water is hygienic enough, clean enough, whether the environment where you are staying, the setup where you are staying is it being cleaned on a daily basis. So all these things. You are also required to take awareness lectures to the troops because they are just 10th pass or 12th pass people, 12th pass individuals. So there will first aid, usual topics are first aid procedures during op related injuries. First aid, how to, because they are the ones you might be in a somewhere different area or a different position. So first aid is must, and it's an important topic for them. And then there is, if you're in a Northeast, then snake bite. If you're in Rajasthan, then there is heat stroke. If you're posted in Siachen or Leh, Ladakh, then it's cold injuries, frost bite, foot, trench foot, all that. So food poisoning, these are the basic, I'm not telling you this medicine, how to manage and all that. It's just a basic, at least basic knowledge, how to do, what to do, what should, they should not do, all these things. You are responsible for their awareness, to bring their awareness to this level. And then there is fitness. There are, every single day there is a fixed routine. There is a discipline that is to be followed, even for the troops and the officers who are posted along with you. The physical fitness. And you are responsible not just the physical, but the mental fitness. Because failed scenario, you are posted as a you are away from your family. There is no supporting system. The supporting system is the rest of the people along with you. So it's important how well you gel with them. So that is about field posting in general. And then this, I want to tell about the post-graduation opportunity. So minimum 4 years of service is required. It is for the eligibility. for you to apply for post graduation in the NEET PG. So it's actually very generous when once you apply and you clear this one, cutoff rankings for serving and ex-servicemen are very generous. Each year the cutoff is different, so you have ample of opportunities to choose what you want to be, or the chances of you getting a PG seat is highly likely in this organization. And you have a great opportunity to do your post-graduation in premier institutes of this country, like Armed Forces Medical College, Pune, Army Hospital Research and Referral, which is located in Delhi. And then there is Command Hospital Air Force, Bangalore, AIMS, New Delhi, PGI, Chandigarh. So there are many prestigious institutes. And it's just coming to the very important point, not just the courses that are offered for post-graduation that are offered by the private and government institutes. There are other myriad or and a different courses that are available are aviation medicine. If you are serving with pilots and you will be, if you do a course in aviation medicine as post-graduation, then you can serve with pilots and Air Force. And then there is sports medicine. Then there is marine medicine for naval officers. And then there is high altitude medicine for army personnel who are serving in Siachen and high altitude. So this is it. This is about post-graduation. And then there is a super speciality. So based on your merit and performance and your gradings, you are eligible for super speciality in, again, Premier AIMS Institute and PGI and AFMC Pune. And also there is a opportunity for you in the organization itself will send you to UK and US for your super speciality in radiotherapy, radio diagnosis, many of the courses that are available. So there are gradings. Coming to the gradings, each and every officer in Indian Army is graded on their performance, how well they have managed under the stressful situation. So your gradings, every single year you are graded. So that gradings will help you in post-graduation and super specialization. Coming to the leave and your allowance part, your pay and allowance part. Leave, you are entitled 80 days in 1 year. So 80 days of leave is divided into 60 days of annual leave and 20 days of casual leave. So annual leave of 60 days and 20 days of casual leave. So annual leave is a paid leave. So, and then casual is just 20 days. Allowance, apart from the salary that you are deriving, you will be allowed with, posted in a high altitude, then you will have a high altitude allowance. If you are posted in a CI ops, that is counterinsurgency operational areas, then you will get, apart from the basic salary, you will have CI ops allowance. Depending upon the ops or the extreme weather conditions, these allowances are awarded for the each and every person. So this is how that is. And then there is accommodation. I have already told you a piece. The families are allowed and entitled, and the organization itself is responsible. They will provide you with the accommodation. But in field scenario, just for you and the families are. The opportunities are just never ending. Foreign assignments are this as a part of the United Nations peacekeeping mission. Peacekeeping mission is all about the army. Basically, Indian Army is deployed in the foreign countries that where there is an international conflict or international operational zones to maintain the situation to maintain peace in those situations. The countries wherein these foreign assignments are in Sudan, Congo, Lebanon, Bhutan, and these friendly countries like Bhutan, Nepal, Mauritius, and New York. So these are again, it's a huge like opportunity for if you opt for United Nations peacekeeping missions. And then there is again there is an interview. There is you have to clear an interview for this assignments, foreign assignments, where you are checked. Where you are assessed for your knowledge about the situation that is prevailing in those areas. So the and again the medical fitness that goes without missing wherever you are posted even for a high altitude posting, for a operationally active areas, for a foreign assignment, for any course that are offered by this organization, a medical certificate, a medical fitness certificate is a must. And then there is okay, I think I have spoken enough about foreign assignments and leaves. And coming to this one more thing, that is, you have, there is an aid to civil authorities. Whenever there is a disaster in the country, whenever there is a disaster, not just here in a foreign country or a friendly country, there is always a rescue operations and Indian Army is being sent for this rescue operations. Like, the disaster, like natural calamities, flood relief, earthquakes. So this rescue op team, you are part of this, integral part of this rescue op team as your sole opportunity to save lives during these crucial times. So you can be proud. I mean, there is no dearth the opportunities that coming to you once you join this organization. So this is about this, and I would like to shed some light on this few things which are very okay. Yes. The lifestyle that you must be having questions about. There are so many adventurous things that are happening, diverse situations. Your life is an adventurer. You will have an adventurous lifestyle. There are many options. You can choose a post-graduation, or you can, without, after just finishing your UG, you can just choose a hospital administration or a super special. There is the super special, becoming super special, super specialist is another opportunity. And then there is a UN mission which you can opt for. And then there are rescue operations. Then the postings, high altitude postings, wherein it's a Siachen Glacier is where the high altitude postings are usually. And it's a world's, as you all know, world's highest battlefield. So this is about that. And then there is, as in personally, I feel you have a lot of with this field and peace tenures coming, matlab alternate peace and field tenures, you will have a lot of opportunities to visit places in and around where you are posted. And then there is you will have an opportunity to learn about this, the localites that are matlab that are wherever you're posted, and the culture of those people, the knowledge about them, about the situation there. It is so much, you're not just a nerd who studies MBBS, who holds a degree and who practices like just a doctor. You are more than that, and you become more than that. And apart from that, once you have, at least by 2-3 years, you will have chance to hear those inspiring stories, martyred souls who have sacrificed their lives. And it's this organization, you have a rich history to know, so you can become part of this prestigious and highly distinguished organization with an illustrious and impressive career. And then personally, at a personal level, I will say that you will respect others a lot. There is a honor, courage, and humility, the discipline that you develop, the sacrifice, the camaraderie, being with the troops who have come from a very humble background. So this is the positive things. And I will be very honest with you all guys regarding, there will be ups and downs, and without them, you will never be able to, reach where you want to. So you become you are not just a savior. You become a warrior for life. And coming to my personal experience, I would like just take 10 minutes on my personal experience, how I joined and what I felt. So the same thing, I also, there was a call interview for this joining soon after finishing my MBBS. There is this, I already told you that www.amccentry.government.in, which is the website for the joining army. So I had applied and they called me for an interview. It was in Delhi and I cleared the interview. And then there was medical. I cleared medical. They called me. There was just within 2 to 3 weeks, I got a 2 weeks. I got a letter and they called me for the, send me with the joining letter. There was a month duration I got, but my parents just said, just go and join. And I did not have time, much time. So I just, I joined. My first posting was in Command Hospital, Pune, which was for a year. I served there for a year. And then I got my training, that is basic course, which was of 6 weeks. And it was such tough time because my parents are still staying in a countryside. But all my life, I was brought up in a residential environment. I was never with my parents. So even though I was never with my parents, by the time I completed my MBBS, I was still like introvert, just focused on what is required, nothing more. No social, not much of a social interactions and mingling with the rest of them. So it was, I was that person. And then once I joined, and when I joined army, I didn't know how to ride a cycle. I didn't know how to ride a bike, and I was definitely never a social social being. I never mingled with people, but everything changed, and there is no other option because you have to, and that's how this organization. Even if you don't want to, you will become a better version of yourself. So that's how. I learned how to ride a cycle. I learned how to ride two-wheeler and hopefully four-wheeler as well in coming days. And then there is, when I was in Pune, I picked up how to speak in Marathi. So that was another advantage. So wherever you go, you pick up so many things. There are so many abilities and things that you learn, knowledge. So it's a good, very, it's a package, I would say. So that's it about my personal experience. And there is no scope for you to, once you join, there is no scope for you to underperform, be it professionally or personally. You will cruise ahead no matter what. And as everybody keeps saying, it's a life less ordinary. So this is about it. So that's it. Yeah, so
we have few doubts, ma'am, in the chat section.
Right. I will answer them.
Yes.
Yes. Thanks. Thank you all for your patience hearing. I would. What are the questions that I've asked? Yeah, this is the one. The White Army has already posted it. The www.amccentry.government.in. This website will be online for a few months in a year whenever there is vacancies. So not you cannot expect because it, since it's a defense website, so it will be active for a few months in a year when there is a vacancy, when there is this interviews going on, when there are results being posted. Yes, I do wear, there is a question from someone asking you wear aprons and you are uniform. Initially, this 2 to 3 months wherein you join, you wear aprons. But once you are commissioned, so I forgot to mention about the commissioning part. So once you have completed MBBS and join as a medical officer, it is always a short service commission. So you complete your 2 years or 3 years of service, and then you are eligible to apply for permanent commission. So what is the difference between short commission and permanent commission? Short commission is wherein it is 5 + 4 + 5, that is totally 11 years of 11 to 14 years of service, and permanent commission is still 45 to 55 years of service, along with pension, and pension is the extra thing that is in the permanent commission. And short service commission, once you leave, there is no pension. So that is it. And then, the uniform. Yes, we do wear uniform after that 2 months or 3 months of joining. After that, we are commissioned and officially commissioned into the organization. And as I do wear uniform. Yes, PG, post-graduation aims and PGI. Yes, it is. There are seats available in defense quota wherein serving and ex-servicemen are our, they have an opportunity to do the PG. How many years since it has been 4 years. Coming July, I'll be major. Can we join after PG? As per my knowledge, no, you cannot. But I will check and let you know. Can we leave army after 4 years? Yes, yes. That is 4 years of minimum, 5 years actually, not 4 years. Minimum short services, minimum 5 years is must. So after that, you can leave. So after getting, this next question is getting entry at PG level is through PG NEET itself, or there are individual exams for it? No, there are no individual exams for institutions. It's just the NEET PG itself. Is there a minimum height criteria? No, there is no height or age. They only check for your deformities, your hearing capacity, ENT, vision testing. And yes, the vision testing, again, they have a criteria like you shouldn't have undergone this LASIK operation and all. There are do's and don'ts again. Well, next question is, what is the minimum years of service to be rendered after the post-graduation done through a sponsored seat? So that is, again, if it depends whether you are a short service commission or a permanent commission. Short service, if you have done your post-graduation from while serving as a short service commissioned officer, then you'll have to extend it for again four years. That is 5 years maximum for minimum for short service, plus 4 years again you have to continue. Will NCC certificates help? Yes, they do help in the interview part. It will impress the board of officers who are interviewing you. Will the MBBS graduate, next question, will the MBBS graduate be given a permit? Yes, yes. After you have joined as a short service commission, after 2 years, 2 to 3 years, basically based on your that yearly grading that I was talking about, your performance, after that, you are eligible for this permanent commission. There is an interview again for the permanent commission. So within that 2 to 3 years of your service, what have you gained? What they will assess again, the interview is about how well you have understood the organization, the organizational needs, what are your aspirations and everything. So there is again, yes, permanent commission is yes. And then medical examination parameters, urine test, blood test, that is fasting, RBC and this CBC, and the urine routine, and then there is this chest x-ray, then abdominal scan, USG, and then basically the bodily deformities, if there is any genuvarum, genuvalgus, all that. So do we need to be physically fit before the interview? No, there is no physical fitness during the interview. But once you get into and during the course, that the basic course that I was talking about, yes, you will, even if you are not fit, you will become fit. That's how this organization, that's how these courses are prepared or scheduled. It's from abroad. Okay, after graduation, your MBBS graduate, you have to clear those MCI exams. where you are eligible to practice in India, and then you can apply for the AMC.Sentry.in. They will call for the interview. You apply, and then once you are selected, you are a short service commissioner officer, and then minimum of 4 years service is must, and after that you can apply for PG. And the next question is, what is the starting salary? Okay, the starting package is 72 to 75, but it depends on the place where you start your profession. I started in a city, so it was 72 to 75. It can be more than that, 76, depends on the place where you are posted. But that is the starting point. 70 is the starting point. What about, they will check you for the deafness, for the visions and everything. Yeah. Can we also join para units? It's such a good question. One who has asked about para units. Yes. After you are minimum 2 years or 3 years of service, you are eligible for this para probation where you are. There's 28 days of para probation. You all know that paratroopers are elite forces of the Indian Army. So you are trained along with them. So like you have to match up their level. So this training is, again, the stress is more compared to the basic course that I was talking about, weapon training, the running, endurance run and everything. So yes, you can join para unit as a doctor, and it's an elite force. So again, you get an extra allowance for being part of that para allowance, extra allowance. So does spectacle disqualify in physical test? No. Where did that question go? Spectacle doesn't disqualify. It's high sight. It depends on the power, actually. Power should be minimum 6 by 36 or something like that, which I am not exactly sure. But there is a limit for the high sight as well. But not for the lower power. Mostly this myopia, high myopia, and all. There is a restriction. Does scarring on leg is disqualification? No, this depends where the scar is and how the extent of scar. Then there is it better to join after MBBS or after? It is better to join soon after MBBS because it's better to know this organization from as early as possible than at a later part. Does appendectomy disqualify? No, doesn't. It doesn't. During which month the army website will be active? That is a good question. Actually, it is. It depends. Actually, whenever there is a large number of vacancy that comes up during that time, but most probably it is during this June, and then March, and in the month of December. What are the ranks? Okay, ranks. I have not told you all about the rank structure. So when you enter as a intern, when you enter in UG as a UG undergraduate, you are a cadet. Once you come to the internship, then you are a lieutenant. Once you complete entire internship and everything, you become a medical officer, which is a captain. So captain, lieutenant is of 1 year, that is 1 year internship, and captain is again 4 years. So you complete 5 years. After 4 years as a medical officer, after 4 years you become a major, and major is again for 7 years. Then after that, you become lieutenant colonel, and then there is colonel and brigadier and everything. Okay, the next question. Yes, after 5 years of service, yes, we can do PG there itself. You are eligible after minimum 4 years of service for this NEET PG. Will a short service candidate get the peace and field posting? Yes. Everybody, it is a cycle. After each piece posting, after each field posting, that is of 2 to 2.5 years, you will get 2 tenures of piece posting, which is of 3 years. Selection? No, as of that, it entirely depend on the your interview, how well you perform in your interview, how well you carry yourself, how confident you are in that interview, and your medicals. That's what matters. This UG marks and no, none of that. Ma'am, you have chosen permanent commission. I have not. I'm keeping my options open, actually. Ma'am, how many hours do you work in a day? It depends where you are posted. Actually, it depends. If you are in a field scenario, you have ample of time because ample of time for yourself and for you to prepare for the PG. And if you are posted in a peace area, that is peace area, you're staying with your families, and even the troops are staying with their families. So there are most of the times it is DMO duties, the emergencies like MI, everything. So, and there are in peace areas, there are always some training sessions happening, courses happening. So your schedule is jam packed in peace areas. Yeah, there is this question. Apart from the cases you see, do you find there is a lack of exposure in certain sense? Like you wouldn't be seeing a number of diseases you would have seen in a non-defense hospital. See, it depends because I don't think there is a lack of exposure because I will tell you, for those doctors who are serving outside this organization, they would have seen this MIs and usual cases, geriatric, pediatric, OBG cases. But any of you has seen high altitude pulmonary edema, high altitude cerebral edema? There are these cases of cold injuries, frostbite, trench foot. We have managed those cases here. And then there is Rocky Mountain spotted fever. So those who have served in these areas were in these mountains, this tribal area. So you will have plenty of opportunities to see these type of, handle these type of cases, gunshot wound or amputations. So you are the first aid provider in these type of situations. I don't think you would have seen these cases in the south and rest of the country if you are serving in a government or a private hospital. So one individual is asking, on the website it is mentioned LASIK is considered provided that it's stable for a period of 1 year. Yes, so after yes, LASIK, I told you, it is a parameter for disqualification. But yes, LASIK, if it is stable after the LASIK operation, if it is stable, your eye power is stable for a year or so, more than a year or so, then you are qualified. It is not you will not be disqualified. Is there a specific time in a year when they call you for interview? There is no specific time that they will, whenever there is, usually it is in April or in the month of June, and then there is this November and December. After 5 years, I leave. Do I be a major or a captain? You will be major because you have put in 4 years of service. So if you have joined as a medical officer, so after 4 years, you are promoted to major. So fifth year, you are major when you leave. What are the chances you are asthmatic? If you are asthmatic, chances are slim. Because asthma is, you might get posted in high altitude where these conditions get aggravated. And for you to finish those probational years or those basic course, you can't, because there are this endurance run, there are 5 kilometers run, there is 2.5 kilometers endurance run where you have to finish in those time period, 25 minutes for the ladies and for the gentlemen cadets, it's different. So you have to finish in those time, and being asthmatic, it doesn't help you. There is one question, ma'am, in field posting, is there any threat to doctors during war or any terror attacks? See, whenever the troops go for operations, they will always have a medical backup. So you are asking a question, this organization said, there will always be a threat in field areas. But it you just have to depend on the troops, on the rest, the officer who is in charge of the operation. They are the solely responsible and for this operation. So yes, there is always a threat. Can we practice well, like in government hospital? The exposure is same or less. See, I can tell you, government hospital, there is a lot of patients, lot of many things. The schedule is jam packed. But you will be seeing the same routine cases, those malnourishment, all those geriatric, pediatric, or surgery cases. But it's a different. I cannot compare. They have their own set of cases, and this organization will provide you another different set of cases. Like I already told you, if you are posted in high altitude, you get to see HACO, HAPO, you get to see cold injuries, frostbite, you get to see Rocky Mountain spotted fever. The next question, what if we join after completing internship from the present medical college? What is the rank and what is the procedure? Okay, there is this question. After completing your internship, you will be commissioned as a short service, that is captain. Your starting rank will be captain. But if you are starting your career as an intern, then you will be joining as a lieutenant. If you are starting as a UG undergraduate, then you are a cadet. So there is this question, if you get in as a SSE, can we convert? Yes. Can we convert into permanent commission? Yes, you can. Ma'am, can we apply soon after 4.5 years, that is before internship? What is this? I didn't get the question. Yeah, ma'am, can 4.5 years of this academic, that is before intern. Yes, after completing your 4.5 years, I've already told you that internship is again one of the way to join, and you will be joining as lieutenant. Okay, what are the things we're supposed to focus in our UG for interview? UG for your interview. The interview is basically how confident you are in answering, how you manage yourself in under those stress situations. The interview, I'll tell you how my interview was. It was such a round table. People are sitting on a round table conference, like how they sit for a round table conference. Board of officers, all specialists, psychologists, psychiatrists, and then there is a presiding officer. So they will start throwing questions at you so fast, and you have to answer fast. You have to be very agile and concentrating while answering all those questions. Ma'am, is posting pattern peace and field same all for 3 Army, Air Force and Navy? For Air Force and Navy, the Navy, you all know, they are usually located in the coastal areas. But in Air Force, they do have their base, Air Force base in Pune and in Siachen as well, high altitude Kashmir as well. So Jammu, so they have their different, they are posting places are field and peace categories in Air Force and Navy is different, and it is different in Army as well. Does knock knees disqualify the test? Yes, because knock knee people have difficulty in running. So they will difficulty in balancing while standing. So it is, it is a disqualification criteria. Ma'am, where are you from? Why did you decide to join Army? This is a very... So I am from Karnataka. My parents do still stay in the countryside. But I was... my education was all throughout. It was in southern part of the Karnataka, that is Mangalore. So my Dr. Kishan, he is my immediate senior. And we studied in
senior,
same school.
Proud senior, not just senior.
Yes.
You're really proud of you, really.
Great. Thank you, Anna. So this is, and we also studied in same. My UG was, and he was doing this UG in the. We did our UG in the same city. So this is, and why did I decide to join Army? Because it happened so fast with me. Everything happened so fast when I applied. Me and my friend, one of my close friend, we both applied online. We were called for the interview, but she said no because her mother was suffering from some terminal illness, and she decided she wanted to be with the family. And my father pushed me, yes, we can go and do, let's see what, how it goes. And I entered, I was interviewed, everything. I cleared, I came back and I got a call later. And my father just said, just go. It's a once in a lifetime opportunity. And I just plunged. So this is how it happened with me. PCOS will be a problematic in selection. Yes, they do screen in USG abdomen is yes. They do screen for your KUB region and the uterus and the ovaries for this for the same purpose. In field postings, do we get to serve the lookalikes there? Yes, yes. As a part of Operation Sadbhavana, the civilians are entertained. The lookalikes who are staying around you, they are also provided with the medical support. Okay. Yes. How can we join Indian Navy after MBBS? The same thing, same procedure. You apply, you are asked for the same interview, and then soon after the interview and the medicals, you are asked to choose between Army, Air Force, and Navy. Depending on your performance in the interview, they will allot the with the grade wise, they will allot you according to your preference. I mean, basically, you are asked for the first preference, second preference, third preference. First is if you want to be Navy, then you choose, then you write Navy. That's how it goes. Okay, then on what criteria are the yearly grading based? Okay, yearly grading is based on your performance. Like how do you perform professionally? How well you, personally, how well you balance under situation? How socializing you are, how do you care the troops? What are the opportunities you have? What are all the opportunities you have taken to create those awareness in the troops? And it's a family, so how well you gel with them, all that comes into picture when they grade you. If by any chance we join PG and after the qualified for AFMC PG, can we join them? Then I did not get this question actually. If by any chance we join in post graduation and after that qualified for, actually I am not able to understand the question, so I will drop that question. What is the minimum NEET cutoff rank to eligible for the interview? Which interview are you talking about? The NEET cutoff marks for qualification for post graduation. It depends on each year. Each year the cutoff marks are different, but it is very generous considering the non-serving or the rest of the individuals who have attended the NEET exams. For the serving and ex-servicemen, it is very generous, and the cutoff is usually less. Very less for these people, and so the chances of getting your choice of seat is highly likely. What will be the pension after retiring? Yeah, the pension, it depends on at what stage you have left the organization. If you have left as a major, if you have completed your tenure as a colonel or a brigadier, each rank wise, it is depends on the how much service you have put in, how much what rank you have left this organization. Is hypertension and diabetes mellitus is contraindicated to join? Yes, of course. It is. You will be disqualified if you have a hypertension and diabetes mellitus. Does inguinal hernia surgery disqualify the medical test? It depends at the point at how after how many years of inguinal hernia you have applied, because by the time you might have got back all those abdominal muscle strength. If at the time of medical test, if you don't have that required abdominal muscle strength, then you will be disqualified. Yes, so I think I have answered most of the questions.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. They have bombarded you with lots of questions. Thank you for the patience, ma'am.
Thank you so much.
Vinita, also provide them details of website wherein they can get the maximum details and how to apply online details, everything available. Please give them the website details, please.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah, and hopefully whenever the captain is free, today it was a very interactive session and our members have shown a lot of interest in joining the army. So keeping this in mind and keeping all our country's interest in mind, we'll have this session again, once again, for the benefit of our members and also for our country. And we need the best of the best doctors in our army. So hopefully our white army contributes for Indian army as well. So, anyway, wonderful, wonderful talk. More than what I expected, Dr. Vinutha. Captain Vinutha, sorry. Yes. depicts army as a very tough job, but there is also a good good part, especially medical personnel treated very well in army, as I suppose. Yes. Am I right?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah,
truly.
High respect. True. And regards, everything in army. So thank you so much, Dr. Vinutha, and we are indeed thankful to you. And any other doubts, you can personally contact us or Dr. Vinutha. Or you can also check in the website details given. And
yes, yes. Yeah. Thank you. Thanks, Anna. Thanks a lot for this opportunity. Hey, thank you all for this patience, yeah, hearing. Yeah. And it's a. I think I have spent.
We wanted to do this from a long time ago, but the problems. She is there with us with all the arrangements for the best possible session. Really grateful to you, Captain. And yeah, hopefully we'll have your session again coming days. Thank you so much.
Yes,
thank you so much.
Yes. Thank you. Thanks a lot, everyone. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.